Starts on the blue line. Hitting center. Comes over the line on the right side. behind. Stops along the boards, plays it behind the net. The right hook. Getting that pass from behind the net from Reinhardt, having a good scoring chance. Puck now, shot. Puck comes back to Todd. He's checked. Kristen comes up to center, takes a hard shot.
Faceoff will come to the left of Dave Snyder. That took 7 seconds.
Snyder wins the draw back in the corner to Cross. Cross now steps out in front of the Hornets net, plays it up to Schnur, out to center to Russ Elliott. Elliott over the blue line on the right side, takes the shot, that's wide. Puck comes around to Cross, he holds it into the left point. Cross plays it off the boards into the right corner to Elliott. To Schnur behind the net, the shot hit the side of the net, another shot stopped by Heap. A couple of good chances there for Schnur. And the puck is shot down the ice by the Mohawks. Dan Burgess going back behind the Cambridge net after it. Just less than half a minute now left in the St. Boniface penalty to Dave Schaller. Here's Roberts over the line, spun around and knocked down to the play. The puck cleared down the ice by John Markwell. And the Hornets once again go back out. 10 seconds left in the Cambridge power play. Cross plays it out to Elliott at center. Over the line with Schnur and Roberts. Back to Roberts. Couldn't control it. Roberts goes into the corner with it. Plays it toward Schnur behind the net. Broken up. Penalty is up to Schaller. And St. Boniface killing off the penalty. Now back at full strength. Puck slides into the Hornet zone where Burgess knocked out from behind. But he already shot the puck up to Russ Elliott. Elliott over the blue line. Drops it back for Duff, intercepted. Here's Luke St. Mars. 2-on-1 with Schaller. St. Mars. Comes around to Schaller. Schaller's pass over to Bobby Hall. Quick shot. That's knocked down in front. Over the line. Takes the shot. That goes off the leg of Jeff Story. Puck comes out to center ice to Brian Crichton. Plays it up to Chapman. Chapman over the blue line on the right side. Checked immediately by Story. Puck goes to Schaller behind the net. He cleared it, not out. Shot from the point by Creighton. Caught by Heaton. And Heaton drops to one knee and covers up to the side of the net. 5 minutes and 3 seconds.
You'll be glad you did. At Carl's House of Fine Furniture and Appliances, don't miss the savings with their huge pre-inventory sale on now. Discover super buys in every department. The fabulous pre-inventory sale. Check it out at Carl's House of Fine Furniture and Appliances, 40 Ainslie Street, downtown Cambridge. The store that gives a little more.
Just past the 5 minute mark in the first period. No score in the hockey game. Bobby Hall over the blue line for St. Boniface. Shot off the goaltender's glove over top of the net. Puck comes around to Luke St. Mars. St. Mars up to the blue line to Schaller, up to center to Bobby Hall, back to St. Mars. St. Mars plays it over to Russ Rankin. Rankin clears it in to Terran, makes the save, the puck coming right along the ice. And Brian Crichton takes it behind the Hornets' net. Around to David Pease, he shoots it down the ice. No icing on the play, Hornets making a line change as the Mohawks go back after. Schaller out to Ristau at center. Ristau over the line, pass to Rankin. Rankin goes in with all the boards, checked by Cross. Puck goes into the corner. Ristau with it, taken to the boards by Strang. And they tie the puck up to the right of the Terran for a faceoff. Is taken by
comes to the left.
inside the line. Kreitzel will try and get it out. Now he decides to go back in the corner and behind his own net. Over to Russ Elliott, who chops it out to center ice. Harry Miller plays it back inside the line offside against St. Boniface. Face off from outside the Cambridge blue line towards the center red line. 7 minutes, 17 seconds gone in the first period. No score. Hornets have Stir, Roberts, and Elliott up front. Wilson and Crichton on defense. Thompson, McDonald, and Christick up front. Here's Roberts at center ice. Checked off the puck. Thompson drops it inside the Mohawks line to Perry Miller. Over to Barkwell. He cleared it outside the line. Schnurr brings it across the line to Roberts. Turned past to Schnurr, broke it up. And the Mohawks have it at center. Thompson clears it in behind to Terran. Back forward is Don Wilson. Wilson chops it around to Russ Elliott. Out to Schnurr at the blue line. Up to Roberts at center. Back to Brian Crichton over the blue line. Pass to Schnurr.
Get in.
In behind the net. Sanders. Roberts is shot. Good play. Now McDonald. Left in the first period. There's no score. You're listening to the Allan Cup Finals on CFTJ.
Clark's TV at a point.
John LeClaire. Go for it, John, and score a goal for Sanderson. Play underway now here at the Galt Arena Gardens with just under 5 minutes left in the first period. No score. Jim Roberts at center ice. Had the puck get away from him. Now McDonald over to Christick. Christick clears it into the Hornets zone. Tataren is out of the net. Playing it around the boards to Roberts. Roberts shooting it, not out. Story at the point. Shooting it in behind the net. Hornets. Neil Thompson in front. The Hornets are going to get a penalty as Russ Elliott touches the puck. And it will be number 22, Dan Fergus, going on for upending Neil Thompson in front of the net. And it is an interference call against.
See how they do tonight on this first one.
Good play by Russ Elliott, checking Perry Miller at the blue line, and the puck comes back to the Mohawks line. Story over to Thompson. Thompson shooting it in. Creighton quickly shoots it back to the St. Boniface blue line. Hornets have Russ Elliott, Dave Chapman, Brian Creighton, and Don Wilson to kill off the penalty to Burgess. Over the line now is Christick. Into the right corner. Back to Story. The shot wide. Puck comes around the boards to Russ Elliott. Elliott tied up along the bull stop in the Hornets zone to the right of goaltender Dave Tataren, and Barkwell and Harry Miller back on defense. Puck comes back to Miller and rifles a hard shot over the crossbar. Now the right point. Barkwell into the corner to Bobby Hall. He's checked by Creighton. St. Mars has it. Back to Barkwell. Over to Perry Miller. Into the side of the net. It goes to Rankin. Centering pass. Shot by Perry Miller is wide. One minute left in the penalty to Fergus. Now Russ Elliott at center ice with it, clears it down the ice. Back forward is Barkwell. Barkwell up to Luke St. Mars. He's taken out of the fire. Great check by Russ Elliott. Now the Mohawks start again inside the blue line. Miller out to Barkwell at center. Up ahead to St. Mars inside the line, a shot at the side of the net. Brighton plays it around, not out. Kept in by Perry Miller. He's checked by Russ Elliott. Puck comes back to Bobby Hall. The shot. Bad save by Tataren. The rebound deflects over the end line. For the most part, some excellent penalty killing. But
in zone, they had some good scoring shots, especially that last one by Bobby Hall at the left point. I'm not sure if Tataren even saw it when he kicked out that right foul and made the save. Then the puck was cleared up into the crowd. Faceoff will come outside the blue line, and the Hornets score.
Savard and Vandergreen on the faceoff. Vandergreen gets it back to Cross inside the line, and he slaps it out to center. Now a loose puck taken by Thiel. Played it off. Vandergreen inside the line. Story brings it back to center. Over to Mazur. Penalty coming up to Savard. And that is an unnecessary penalty to take for the center. seconds left in Fergus's penalty, so the Hornets will have a man advantage in 9 seconds. That's exactly what we talked about in the pregame show, is that the Mohawks cannot afford to take needless penalties.
Yeah, those are the ones that really seem to come back and haunt you, especially with the Hornets' power play working so well in the last couple of games. John Vandergreen caught inside the St. Boniface blue line. Sparks hauled him down. Now both clubs will be even strength for the next 5 seconds or so. Then the Hornets will have the power play for the rest of the period.
Puck goes in behind the Hornets, then to John Vandergreen. Fergus steps out of the penalty box. Hornets with a man advantage now. Third power play of the period for Cambridge. Puck cleared in behind the Mohawks net. Dave Peace trying to center it. It comes back to Fergus. Along the boards to Vandergreen. Back to Fergus. Fergus shooting, and it goes off the stick of Sutton to the far corner. Reinhardt with it. Reinhardt along the boards. Back to Cross at the point of shot. Bounces off the stick. Sutton gets a hold of it and bangs it down the ice. Cross goes back after it for Cambridge. Just over a minute left in the penalty to St. Boniface. Cross over the blue line was Pokechek. Peace has the puck. David Peace along the boards, checked. Now it goes around the back of the St. Boniface net. Reinhardt centers it right in front of the goal and it's taken away by McDonald and shot to center ice. Fergus over to Dave Peace. Inside the blue line. Peace checked by Story and Schaller plays it to Mazur. Mazur over the line, a shot. Bounces off Fergus to Tarrant, catches it. And we'll get a face-off to the right of the Hornets net. 1:09 left in the first period, no score.
5 power play minutes that the Hornets have had, they haven't really been able to set up very well, and they haven't had the real good scoring chances that they got last night.
1 minute now remaining in the period. Here's Schnurr to center. Schnurr shooting it over the blue line. Goes into the corner. Cleared it behind the net. The goaltender hit by Russ Elliott. Elliott now is slashed by Perry Miller. Goaltender is down and injured. Russ Elliott ran into the goaltender. Goaltender is injured. Russ Elliott's getting a penalty. And St. Boniface would have been playing 5-a-side, but Harry Miller gets a slashing penalty for going after Russ Elliott after he ran into the goaltender.
Well, Russ Elliott, the goaltender, Jim Heaton, obviously collided. I didn't see what happened. Oh, I saw Heaton go down, but Russ Elliott got a penalty for it. Here's Miller's call. Elliott gets the original slashing call.
Well, Russ Elliott obviously caught the goalie with his stick. The goalie went down, and Russ Elliott was being penalized 2 minutes for slashing, and then Harry Miller went after Russ Elliott and slashed Russ Elliott across the side of the helmet. So both players go off 2 minutes for slashing tonight. Any unnecessary yapping from the players? For 2 minutes, and so the Mohawks will be shorthanded, and the Hornets will finish the period with a man advantage here, Randy.
Well, St. Boniface, again, like last night, getting into penalty trouble late in the period, really unnecessary penalties, too. You look at the holding call against Savard, that was unnecessary. The slashing call against Russ Elliott, that was more of a retaliation thing. And now the 10-minute misconduct and the automatic 2-minute minor. St. Boniface working themselves into a hole again.
And the Mohawks have played a very good first period here. And similar to last night, they're getting themselves in penalty trouble late in the first period. They, for the most part, have played a good first period here tonight. They've skated well in the first period and passed the puck around well. And now they're getting into some penalty trouble. Hockey game, we're in the last minute here, 51 seconds left in the first period. Puck cleared to the line, but not out. Cross winds up. Slap shot is wide. Puck goes around to Schnurr. Schnurr knocked down from behind. Puck comes outside the blue line to Schaller. Up to Thompson. Thompson clears it in to the Hornet zone. The puck behind the net. Roberts picks it up there. 30 seconds left in the period. Here's Roberts to center. Over the line. Back it comes to Schnurr. The shot deflected in front. Roberts back to Fergus. Fergus plays it to an open wing. Puck is taken by Thompson and shot out to center ice. 12 seconds left in the period. Hornets with a one-man advantage. Schnurr up to Robert, or to Cross, over the line to Fergus, cutting in front, the shot. Good save by Heaton, and the save coming with only 1 second left in the period.
Good save by the goaltender, who was just...
Well, the Mohawks had too many men on the ice for this faceoff. Now they'll take it. Thompson and Bob Peace. 1 second left, right from the faceoff. The puck goes wide of the net, and there goes the buzzer to end the first period of play. Cambridge Hornets having more power play opportunities than the Mohawks. And both teams playing a pretty even first period of play with the score 0-0 after 20 minutes. Randy?
Now you in town.
Win a Commodore Big 20 computer with Pepsi.
Win a Commodore Big 20 computer with Pepsi. Look, a new special cat. It's all so easy. A pop of Pepsi, a Mountain Dew, a Diet Pepsi, or a Pepsi free.
We have 1,000 Commodore Big 20 computers up for grabs in Ontario alone. So grab yourself a Pepsi now and nab one. Contest info wherever Pepsi is sold.
Hornets on the power play to start the period. Start the period has given Cambridge a 1-0 lead here in the second period. Teams at 5-a-side now. Vandergreen over the blue line, past the crease. Puck goes into the corner to Field. Field, side of the net. Banner's over. Hard to win by. Vandergreen a shot. And down. Just goes wide of the net. Mohawk shooting around. Now they're to the point by Ristau. The Hornets with a 2-0 lead. Now Bobby Hull, front to Barkwell, a shot over the glass into the stands. And the crowd really excited, 2-0. Now John LeClair out at center ice. Back handing it into the St. Boniface zone. Heaton is down to cover up and will get a faceoff to the left of the Mohawks net.
Much as we've seen it all year long, last night with St. Boniface fell behind by a few goals, they just seemed to die. If they die tonight, it's season over. We'll just have to wait and see if they do it. I don't think they will. I mean, they really can't afford to. They may as well give it everything they've got until the very end, but we'll just have to wait and see. Hornets with two quick goals, one by Reinhardt, one by Vandergreen, and Cambridge leads 1-0.
Both goals pretty... Both goals, Randy, pretty passing plays. Vandergreen to Reinhardt at the side of the net. He put it in. And then Russ Elliott to Vandergreen. And he found the open corner. The Terran shooting the puck into the crowd. And we'll get a face-off to the left of the Hornets net. Now we got some words being exchanged after the whistle. Luke St. Mars and John LeClair and Bob Peace having words. Fans booing the Mohawks. Face-off. 2 minutes, 2 seconds. Gone in the second period, and the Hornets have a 2-0 lead. Puck is cleared down the ice inside the St. Boniface line. Barkwell's pass misses Miller, and David Peace plays it deep into the St. Boniface zone. Players fight for it along the boards. Now they tie the puck up in the corner. We've got some pushing.
Oh, yeah.
Peace and Luke St. Mars pushing.
Go.
John LeClair in there pushing one of the Mohawks.
Doug Rob
will handle penalties here.
Yeah, he
disappointing by a lot, like maybe 4 or 5. They'll be getting very frustrated. Could lead to a lot of chippiness.
On the base side, it's in behind the Mohawks. Net cleared by Leskin. Up ahead to center to Christick. Over the line to Thompson. The pass went off and back to Jim Roberts. Now Roberts starting out. Roberts up the center ice. Takes the shot. Quick save by the goaltender. He leaves it behind the net. Cross. Leskin go to the boards and frees it behind the Mohawks net.
Center ice.
Fergus to Reinhardt. Shooting it over the blue line, stopped by Bobby Hall Jr., and he backhands a high shot down the ice. Back behind the Hornets net with it is Cross. Up ahead to Fergus at the blue line, the center ice. Crossing the St. Boniface line, puts on the brakes, takes a shot towards the net, blocked by Story, and he bangs it off the boards. Here's a break for... scoring chance for the Mohawks. Now here come the Hornets. Reinhardt up the center ice. Over the blue line. Back to Cross. The shot. Of course, following the goal, the penalty is expired, and St. Boniface, they're back in full strength. Hornets have three goals, two of them on the power play. Over the line now is Harry Miller. Over to Kristick. He's checked. Tuck comes back to the point to Burke. Well, a shot to Terran makes the save and holds on to the rebound. Faceoff will come to the left of the net. To Terran having words with Darryl Sutton.
They had to start capitalizing on their power plays. They've got one right now.
There's a shot from the point by Burke. Well, stopped by to Terran. The Hornets get it down the ice. Goaltender Heaton is out of the net. Playing it around the boards for Kristick. Out to center to Thompson. Thompson over the line, offside. Burkwell in ahead of the play. So that'll bring a face up. Puck goes to Crichton inside the line. He bangs it off the far boards to center ice. Harry Miller with it. Over to Kristick. Kristick plays it over to Miller. Over the line, offside again against the Mohawks. Face off at center ice. Puck is dropped. Mazur gets it back to his defenseman, Barkwell. Over to Miller. Miller's pass intercepted by Russ Elliott. And Elliott shoots it down the ice. 1 minute, 15 seconds left in the penalty to Greg Broughton. Hornets with a 3-0 lead. Approaching the midway point of the second period. Here's Savard with a shot. That's stopped by Tataren, and he holds on for the faceoff.
Well, Dave Tataren's certainly here to play tonight. He scored more goals here in the playoffs. He's already got 12.
Now a little bit of movement on the faceoff. Now they'll take it. Savard and Chapman. Puck comes to the boards to Mazur. Mazur back to the point to Schaller. The shot is blocked. Left and could not hold on to the puck to get the shot away. Now the puck comes down inside the Hornet line and Cross slaps it down the ice. 32 seconds left in the Hornets penalty to Broughton. Here comes Story now out to the line and past the center ice. Goes off Mazur to Fergus and Fergus shoots it down the ice. Time running out on the power play. The Mohawks, who trail 3-0. Now at the center ice, Bobby Hall Jr. Hall over the line, he's checked. Puck comes back, the shot by Story, and that goes up into the end seats.
Hamill's back on that shorthanded situation. The power play made a good deke on the goaltender, but Heaton picked out that left leg and made the save.
Okay, Randy Broughton's back on the ice now as they drop the puck. Penalty it's up to the Hornets. And they're back at full strength. In behind the Cambridge net, Thiel around to Reinhardt. Reinhardt flips it over the boards into the bench. Once again here tonight in a game that his team wants to win the cup. Tataren is playing sharp again. Now Bobby Hall behind the net, centers it, blocked by Thiel. Out to LeClaire. LeClaire's pass for Peace broke it up by Schaller, and he shoots it back in on goal. Tataren stops that. Plays it off the boards outside the line. It's cleared in offside. Delayed offside here. They're not going to whistle it down because the Hornets are coming out with it. Thiel up to LeClaire. Over the line to Bob Peace. He deflects it into the corner. Story back for it. In behind the net to Schaller. Round the boards to Rankin. And Rankin gets it to the line and out. back in offside.
The salesmen at Rich Hill Ford believe in their product, and for good reason. They're selling the brand new 1983 Ford line. They're selling the best, and that's what you deserve. Rich Hill Ford, 217 Hespeler Road in Cambridge, where they say service is not our motto, it's our business.
Just approaching the 10-minute mark in the second period. Hornets with a 3-0 lead. Teams at full strength right now play inside the Mohawks' blue line. Campbell back in the corner with it. Campbell shooting it along the boards, not out, blocked by Russ Elliott. Now Campbell gets a second try, and this time gets it out to Thompson at center ice. Thompson takes the shot wide off the backboards, picked up by Brian Cross. Cross losing it behind the net to Gerard McDonald. McDonald gave it right back to Cross, and Cross clears it out to center ice. Roberts racing after it. Back to Schnurr. Schnurr into the corner. Trying to center it. Went out the back of one of the Mohawk skates, and now it's cleared outside the line to center ice. McDonald, a shot. Good save to Tarrant, doing the splits to kick that out. Puck goes in behind the net. Krestick picks up the loose puck, centers it back to Leskin. Leskin right in on goal, shooting, and he shot it wide. Great scoring chance for Mark Leskin, and he just shot it wide for point-blank range. Now Schnurr up to Roberts. Roberts out at center, long shot, bullet drive, wide of the net, comes off the corner glass to Cross. Cross trying to find Roberts. Gets it to Roberts, and from the Vandergrain, he tipped it wide. Back to Burgess, the shot. Oh, off the leg wide. Now Cross takes the shot. That hit Russ Elliott. Puck goes into the corner. Elliott, Commander Green, behind the net. Centers it. Puck goes into the corner to Vander Green. Back to the point to Cross, the shot. That goes off the skate wide. Puck goes in behind the net. Hornets putting on the pressure as the Mohawks finally shoot it down the ice.
In the first 6.5 minutes, Reinhardt, Vandergreen, and Cross, and Cambridge leads 3-0.
Left here in the second period. John Vandergreen, Carl Reinhardt, and Kevin Strang up front for the Hornet, back on the blue line. Neal and Crichton.
We go. I guess it's clear.
Now Sutton will take the face off. Here's Vandergreen. Vandergreen wins it. The shot blocked. Green is wide.
All by himself, he almost won the first game of this series. Hornets trailed 3-1, and Vandergreen scored two of three Cambridge goals in the last 9 minutes to pull out a 4-3 win and give the Hornets the early jump in the series. They just haven't looked back since.
Off the boards, down inside the blue line. Ristau going after to Tarrant out of the net. Plays it over the glass into the crowd. And we'll have a face-off. That's right, the Tarrant has been a big part of this Hornet hockey club in the playoffs. He kept the Hornets in that game in the first period at Stephenville, the deciding game, game five, last Tuesday. Here we go on the face-off now to the left to Tarrant. The puck goes into the corner to Fergus. Around the boards to Duff. Duff goes behind his own net, scoops it around the boards, too far for Cross. Now Cross does catch up to it. Plays it along the boards, but not out. Now Fergus picks up a loose puck and takes it back behind his own net. Fergus, caught with a stick by Sutton. Knocked down, no penalty. The Hornets clear it out to center ice. Barkwell with it to Perry Miller. Up to Sutton, and Sutton backhands it down into the Hornet zone. Fergus back after it. Clearing it around to Greg Broughton. Broughton shooting it to the line, not out. Perry Miller's shot blocked by the stick of Broughton. Now Fergus, Cross fires it off the boards, and now there's going to be a hooking penalty just at the top of the circle to the right of the Hornets' net. Puck now cleared by the Hornets. Brian Cross down the ice. And going back after it is number two, Jeff Story. Story behind the net to Schaller. Schaller now being watched by Chapman. Plays it over in the corner to Story. Out to center to Russ Rankin. Rankin over the line. Drop pass for Hall.
Tatarin, the save, and he holds on. Big save by Tatarin.
He's in the Dave Duff minor.
Puck comes back off the faceoff to the point to Story into St. Mars. Into the corner behind the net to Rankin. Went by him, and now Russ Elliott finds a loose puck and clears it out to center ice. Goes off the defenseman skate inside the blue line. Story quickly after it, shooting it out to center. St. Mars had it, lost it to Russ Elliott. And Elliott clears it off the boards inside the St. Boniface blue line. Mohawks come to center. St. Mars checked by Elliott. Elliott forces a faceoff.
Those two have really combined for a super penalty-killing effort. They're doing it again here in this series. They're doing it again tonight.
Now number 19, Krestick upended by Elliott. Puck cleared by Crichton down the ice. And back forward is Barkwell. Barkwell clears it back of his own net to Perry Miller in the corner. Miller shooting it out to Neil Thompson to center ice. Thompson over the blue line. The pass to Krestick right in front of the net. Thompson. Now the puck in front of the net, cleared by ejections. Dave Tatarin using that stick to the fullest. He got it down on the pass in front of the net. Two Mohawks are right in front of the net. Puck is knocked ahead with a glove. We'll have a face.
Only 9 seconds left in Dave Duff's minor.
On the face off, the puck goes into the Mohawks corner. Bob Peace and Perry Miller.
Come on.
amazing because with Zenith, the quality goes in before the name goes on. At Clark's TV and Appliances, 76 Stanley Street in Ayer.
It'll take your breath away with its European styling, bold, daring lines, and slipstream shape. It's the all-new Thunderbird for 1983, on display now at Rich Hill Ford. The legend lives on in a new era of Thunderbird. Thunderbird Heritage, and now the Thunderbird Turbo Coupe. Thunderbird, shaped by the wind to soar in...
5 minutes of fighting, the game is gone, there's an automatic fight. All five guys are on the ice with the gun. Both sides. The last element.
11-20, and the indoor. Double final, first off the bat. 5 minutes of fighting, the game is gone, there's an automatic fight, and the last element.
53 remaining here in the second period.
Well, Glenn was exactly right. You look at the Hornets who are left out there. Vandergreen and Reinhardt are both out there. Those two have played just superbly.
We've got 11 skaters and to turn for the Hornets. So the Hornets still have more players and manpower. And right now we're going to get back to hockey. Allan Cup tonight. Or early tomorrow morning, whichever the case may be. 3-0 Hornets, face-off will come at center ice. Dartwater will come outside the Mohawks' blue line. And the teams will stay at their respective ends until the end of this period. And the 5-4, St. Boniface with the advantage. And play continues here in the second period. 3-0 Hornets. Now Bobby Hull at center, over the line, is shot deflected off Creighton's stick over the end glass. And we'll get a face-off.
Put it out very well. They're all here. Most of them are still here. No reason to leave, really.
Now, puck comes back to Schaller. His shot blocked by Don Wilson. Reinhardt tried to shoot it outside the line. Missed it. Now he ties it up with Rankin in the corner. And we'll get a face-off to the right of Dave DeTerran. Hornets playing shorthanded here for the next 4 minutes, or 3 minutes and 32
seconds. Very tired hockey clubs when the final buzzer goes tonight.
Now the puck comes back to the point to Schaller into Bobby Hull in the corner. Back to the point it comes to Schaller. Over to Story. Story's shot deflected. He scores! Bobby Hull Jr. deflecting the shot to the point of the power play goal. Hornets will stay a man short because of the length of the penalties. And the Mohawks are on the scoreboard in case anything further breaks out here in this hockey game. Now Schaller inside his own line for the Mohawks. Comes out to center being watched by Roberts. 2 minutes, just under 2 minutes left in the Cambridge penalty. Then they'll be back at five aside. Puck goes into the corner to the left of DeTerran. Rankin with it. In front to Schaller, and he's checked before he can get the shot away. Rankin back to Story. Story takes the shot, to tear in the save, and Creighton moves the puck out of there and clears it out to center ice.
Now Hall, over the line. Pass in front. Nobody there for St. Boniface. Creighton clears into the line, but not out. Schaller plays it in behind the Hornets' net. Don Wilson with it. Donnie Wilson clearing it off the boards and down the ice. Coming up to 1 minute left in the Hornet penalty, and then there'll be five aside. Now Schaller at center ice. Shooting an end off the corner boards. Creighton after it. He bangs it up to Reinhardt. Reinhardt deflects it down the ice. The goalie racing out after it. And he plays it out to center ice. Now Cross at center. Back to Thiel at the blue line. Thiel sends it down the ice. 35 seconds. And the Hornets will be back at equal strength. Now it's McDonald over the line. He's checked by Cross. Offside call against the Mohawks.
On the penalty clock to St. Boniface, most of those penalties were racked up by Andy Ristau.
2.5 minutes remaining in the second period. Hornets leading 3-1. Over the line is Laskin. Laskin back to the point to McDonald. Over to Campbell. The shot is wide. Comes around the boards. Reinhardt deflects it down. Backhanding it into the corner, Mazur in after it. Mazur, back to the point, it comes, a shot by McDonald, kicked out by Tatarin. Broughton and Campbell go to the boards, Broughton comes up with it, and skates behind his own net. Pass around to Gary Thiel, out to Senator Reinhardt. Reinhardt lost it off his stick, and Mazur's got it. Mazur comes to the Hornet line, is poke checked by Cross. Now the Mohawks shoot it in. Leskin picks up the loose puck. Leskin takes the shot wide. But comes back to the point. Campbell. Pass to Mazur, went by him. Thiel gets it along the boards, not out. Now Broughton and Mazur tie it up. And we'll get a face-off inside the Hornet blue line with a minute 20 left in the second period.
When Kevin Strang returns from the penalty box.
Now Bobby Hall takes a hard shot. Almost took to Terrence. Puck goes into the corner. Don Wilson knocks down Rankin. Hall in to help out. Plays it back to the point to Schaller. Schaller. Along the boards to Rankin. Penalty coming up to the Hornets. Brighton touches the puck. And the Cambridge Hornets are going to
Roberts goes over to serve the penalty to Dave Tatarin. 19:04, the time of the slashing minor to the Hornet goaltender. Faceoff will come to the left of the Cambridge net.
Hornets have Reinhardt, Crichton, and Wilson out here. Hull, Rankin, Story, and Schaller for St. Boniface. Puck is dropped, period. Hornets with a 3-1 lead. Puck comes back to Schaller, a shot. Tatarin got a piece of that. Another shot by Story. Tatarin stops that. Now it comes back to Schaller. Along the boards into the corner to Rankin. And Don Wilson freezes the puck for a face.
Kevin Strang for a good minute after Kevin Strang gets out of the box.
Brian Creighton stops it down the ice. And now just half a minute remaining in the second period. Hornets shorthanded. Bring it out to center. Rankin with it. Over to Schaller. Steps inside the line. Clears it in behind the Cambridge net. Tatarin is out of the goal, playing it around the boards to Reinhardt. And he deflects it out to center. Creighton with it. Checked off the puck by Schaller. Schaller now moves up to center ice. Story shooting it into the Hornet zone. And there goes the buzzer to end the second period. There will not be an intermission. We'll just have a short break to change ends, and we'll carry on.
He tried to bat it down with his hand, but never did get a good shot away, but good effort by Kevin Strang.
Now out at center ice, Reinhardt installed the man advantage. From the faceoff, it goes to Schnurr. Back to Cross at the blue line. Roberts back on the ice now after serving to Terrence penalty. And the Hornets have the man advantage for 3 minutes. Here comes Snurr to center ice. And he decides to turn back to the blue line. Now up ahead to Crichton at the blue line. Crichton shooting it into the St. Boniface corner. Puck goes around the net. Reinhardt after it. He's checked off. The puck gets it again to Snurr in front. Snurr shooting his head. Remaining now in the third period. That's how much time the Hornets are away from the Allen Cup. Puck goes down the ice. Brian Cross back behind the net. Now Cross starts out to the blue line to center ice. Puck to Snurr. Snurr in a goal. Back to Roberts. Reinhardt goes directly to the dressing room. He caught a high stick in the corner down below us. Maybe a puck. Stick or a puck, doesn't really matter. He's been cut. And he's gone to the dressing room. Now it's fighting up to Roberts. Roberts to center ice. Over the line. Right it on goal. Centers. Comes off the corner boards, the goalie plays it over to the boards. Broughton's got it. Behind the net, tries to jam it in the short side, the goalie stops it. Now it's cleared by Story, off the boards and down to the Hornet blue line. Backboard is Cross. Up to Kevin Strang. Strang over the blue line. Clears it in behind the net. Goalie catches it on the bounce. Holds on for the faceoff. 13 seconds left in the Mohawks penalty. Hornets leading 4-1.
Haven't yet, but he was in a bit of pain as he skated off.
Vandegrift wins the faceoff to Strang along the boards. Strang turning in the corner with it. Check by Leskin. And they tie it up for a faceoff to the right of the Mohawks net. 16 minutes, 23 seconds, the time remaining in the third period, and the Hornets have a 4-1 lead.
Checking the final, Cambridge 11, St. Boniface outshot the Hornets 4-2 after we returned to complete the second period.
Vandegrift wins a faceoff to Strang and centers it. It comes off a Mohawk stick. Now, Strang again, a shot just wide. Puck rebounds all the way down the ice. And Don Wilson is back to pick it up. 13 players not in the game right now as a result of that bench clearing brawl in the second period. Now Vandegrift over the line offside Cambridge. And we'll have a face-off outside. The Mohawks
lead by 3. Scores 4-1.
Schnurr and Bobby Hull Jr. in the face-off. Puck is dropped. It goes to the center red line to Roberts. Over to Schnurr off his stick. And Rankin shoots it down onto Tarrant. To Tarrant, leaving it behind the net for Brian Crichton. Over to Wilson. Who clears it up to Chapman at center. Went off him to Campbell, who shot it to the Hornet line. Here comes Brian Crichton. Over the blue line. Into the corner behind the Mohawks net. Centers it. Roberts couldn't get a stick on it. Crichton now with it at the point. Into the corner to Roberts. Roberts trying to center it. It goes behind the net. And Bobby Hull picks it up. And Hall starts up the right side. Center ice. Over the line. Cuts in behind the net. Centers it with one hand on the stick, blocked by Schnurr. Schnurr standing behind the Cambridge net. 5 minutes gone here in the third period. Cambridge leading 4-1. Schnurr still behind the net. Clears it into the Cambridge corner to Chapman. Back to Schnurr into the corner to Wilson. Wilson clears it on the boards. Not out. Now gets it again and freezes it. So face off. Now the puck goes behind the net to Clayton. Up ahead to Wilson. And he comes to center ice. Wilson shooting it down into the Mohawk zone. The puck goes behind the net to Campbell. Campbell up ahead to Russ Rankin. Over to Leskin. Leskin comes to center ice. Check by the right.
You just run out of bread or milk? Well, don't panic. You see, Cambridge has 5 quickie minute markets ready to serve you. That's right, 5 Cambridge quickie minute markets. So wherever you are, there's a quickie minute market ready to serve you.
Time. John Vandergreen out there. Hornets still have that line of Reinhardt and Strag, should they want to use it. But right now, Carl Reinhardt is getting a rest with the injury to his face after being hit with the puck. And Greg Broughton is out there taking his place on the right side of that line with Vandergreen. And Kevin,
the last game of the season, Randy. Our voices are working overtime. Here comes Story to center ice now for the Mohawks. Shooting it in, saved by Tatarin, and he leaves it for Cross. Round to Broughton, went by him. Schuyler's shot, stopped by Tatarin, and a whistle on the play. Faceoff will come to the right of the Hornets' net.
We could use some more of Aunt Barb's special remedy right about now. We had it going in the first period, but it kind of ran out in the second.
In what has been a wild hockey game, after a bench-clearing brawl in the second period. Puck cleared down the ice into the Mohawk zone, backboard is Story. Round the boards, Roberts intercepts, lost it off the stick. Here's Mazur now with it. Shooting it out the center, Wilson intercepts. Over to Crichton. Crichton steps over the blue line, clears it in wide of the net. Rebound taken by Hull. Around the boards to McDonald, and McDonald plays it over to Mazur. Mazur at center ice. His pass for Story behind him. Crichton has it, and he shoots it on the Mohawk side of center. Bobby Hull over to McDonald. He clears it into the Hornets' corner. Backboard is Crichton. Crichton circles the net. Up ahead to Chapman. To Crichton, center ice. Over the blue line. Takes the shot wide. Puck goes into the corner to Schaller, and he gets it out to center ice. Hornets clear it in again. Number 33, Schaller, shooting it outside the blue line, Strang with it. Over to Broughton. Broughton clears it right into the stands below us. And that puck just missed hitting the glass, went over the glass. And we'll have a...
We'll make it for that one, but... St. Boniface is going to have to come back in this game to force a game tie on Wednesday.
Puck goes in behind the Mohawks net. Leskin picks it up. Shooting it around to Mazur. Gets it out to the line. Kept in by Thiel. His shot is wide. He's off the backboards. Campbell shooting it. Not out. Cross the shot right on. Stick saved by the goalie Heat. Puck goes into the corner to Broughton. Broughton. Pass in front. Puts back to Thiel. Cross, who gets it to Vandergreen, waiting for Strang. Vandergreen to Strang,
When people think pizza, they think Pepe's Restaurant, and that's good. But Pepe's also offers a wide menu of other taste delights. Come discover fine dining and friendly service at a restaurant license for one.
They seem to be on their way to the Allan Cup. We got 10 minutes to go. Right, the shot, left side by here.
It really keeps the club close. St. Boniface could be out of it right now. They could be packing their bags for home, or not for a few fine saves by Jim Heath in the last 4 or 5 minutes of play.
From the face-off, it goes in behind the Mohawks net. Story shooting it out the center ice. And Don Wilson takes it back inside the Hornet play line. Up to Roberts. Over to Schnurr. Schnurr now, starting up from the Hornet line, turns back. Lays it to Clayton. Up the center to Roberts. Roberts backhands it into the Mohawk zone. Schaller back for it. Played it around the boards. Gets it back and in behind the net, shooting it around the other side. Don Wilson keeps it in. Schaller has it again behind the net. Plays it to Jeff Story. Now Story gets it out to center ice. Schaller shooting it to the Hornet line. Schnurr has it. Gary Field.
He should
now
be.
Moving it out the left side.
He's going to go back.
Clearing it out to center to Roberts. Oh! And he's checked off the puck and knocked down by Field. Field's waiting for a penalty. There isn't one. And the Mohawks get him out to center ice. Puck cleared over the blue line. Campbell shooting it out to center ice. Reinhardt shoots it back over the blue line. Campbell at center. Campbell dumps it down the ice. And the Hornets come back behind their own net. Gary Field. The cross in the corner. Coming up to the 11 and a half minute mark. Hornets leading by 3-0. Pass Graham moves it over the Hornets zone. A pass right on the stick of Reinhardt. His shot is at the point. It's stopped by Heath. Puck goes to the board. They hold up for a face-off. And St. Boniface side. Schnurr back to Roberts. The shot hit the side of the net. Roberts in behind the goal with it. Looking for someone to pass it to. Plays it to Schnurr. Schnurr in the corner. Couldn't get it back to Roberts, and it's taken away by Bobby Hall. It's pass misses. Mazur icing calling in St. Boniface. 7:56 remaining in the third period. The Hornets leading 4-1. In our broadcast booth right now is John LeClaire. It's Roberts, tied up by Hall, and we'll get a face-off over it. Couldn't get it, and Story shoots it out the center. Crichton over to Wilson. Wilson flips it into the Mohawk zone, wide of the net. Back forward is Story. Gets away from Chapman and gets it up to Mazur. Bobby Hall takes it at center. Hall shooting it over the blue line. Puck goes out Crichton into the corner. Wilson dunks it around to Broughton. Broughton flips it down the ice. This will be icing against the Hornets. No, it's waved on. Back forward is Luskin. Luskin trying to get away from Strand. Check, he lost his stick. Schaller takes over. Schaller over the Hornet line. Trying to get around Field. Field took him out. Now Strand back behind the net with him. Strand off the boards to Reinhardt at center. Reinhardt shoots it into the Mohawk zone. Goaltender leaves it to the side of the net. Flips it into the corner. And Leskin has it back behind the Mohawks net. Around the boards. Clearing it out the center to Rankin. Rankin checked at the blue line by Thiel. Thiel gets it outside the line. And Rankin takes it back in. Shooting it into the corner, back for to Thiel. Round across. Ryan Cross starting out the center ice. Shooting it down into the Mohawk zone. Vandergreen after it. The goalie flips it off the boards. And it's taken by Rankin. Rankin, almost checked by Vandergreen. Rankin ahead to Sutton, and he gets it outside the line to Story. Shoots it on the Cambridge side of center, now it's inside the blue line, back forward is Reinhardt. 5:19 left, 4-1 for the Hornets. Now Roberts, over the line, Chapman, takes the shot. Shooting it into the Mohawk zone. Chapman finds the loose puck. Back to Wilson. Wilson shot deflected by Broughton in front of the net, taken away by Story. He shoots it. Not out, blocked by Roberts. Chapman and Sutton go to the board screen.
The video station is now open in Cambridge. Stop into the video station and get 50% off your movie club membership and experience the pleasure of watching first-run movies in the comfort of your home. Become a member of the world's largest video network, the video station in the Bishop Gate.
4.5 minutes remaining in the third period. Shot from center snare at center. And it is a two-line offside call against the Hornets. And we have whooped on their first Allen Cup since 1971.
It's been a long time coming, and you really got to feel happy for a lot of these Hornet players who have waited a long, long time for this. In particular, John LeClair standing right between us. Players like Dave DeGeron, Dave Beast, Bob Beast, Carl Reinhart.
Now it goes to Cross behind the Hornets net. 4-1 for Cambridge. Cross comes out the right side, plays it out the boards to Reinhart at center. Over the blue line, shooting it in. Backboard is Schaller, 1:37 left. Shot. Another shot.
average fine cars, the definition of new technology and innovative techniques is the Volkswagen Rabbit. Today's answer to fuel efficiency, sure-footed handling, and dynamic looks. Come see the fine selection of Rabbits at Cambridge Fine Cars. Buy now. They want your good used trade-ins. Test drive the Rabbit GTI, an experience in itself. And from now until April 30th, take advantage of 12.75% financing on any new, used, or demonstrator vehicle. That's ordinary ridges that make Rubbles crunchy. Look for regular and barbecue flavor in the big bags, and all four flavors in the small bags. That's regular, barbecue, sour cream and onion, and new zesty cheese flavor. Four kinds of Ruffles so you can spread your love around.
Right now they're presenting the Allan Cup to the Cambridge Hornets at center ice.
Serving Hamilton, Toronto, and the Niagara Peninsula, this is THDH TV 11.
Thank you, looking good.
What did you have after the escargot?
Some kind of a veal dish.
Some kind of veal dish?
Yeah, with some kind of a delicious sauce on it.
Oh, come on. Details. I want details.
Okay. For dessert, I had the most fabulous hot chocolate souffle, cooked to a perfect crispness around the edges, with two globs of fresh whipped cream on the top that melted in my
mouth. That's more like it. What else?
Coffee with sweetener.
Oh, I'm glad to see you watching your diet.
Of course.
And then what?
That's it.
I mean, later, what happened?
Nothing.
Nothing?
It was a nice evening, Caroline.
Nice?
It doesn't have to be sexual to be good.
That's right, I forgot.
You're impossible.
No, actually, as a matter of fact, I'm easy.
Oh, yeah? Hello?
We found him.
What?
We found Larry. Sam, you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine, Jim.
He lives in a little town up north. We don't know the details yet, but we do know that Larry Candell now holds the orders to appear in court in his surprise little fist.
Well, what do we do now?
We see him in court. But don't you worry about that. That's my job.
Thanks, Jim.
I'll talk to you soon.
Well, what do you know?
Go, John!
Come on, John!
Go, go, go! Yes, all right. John, you beat your time by 5 seconds. All right.
Phil, let's get these turkeys back to school.
Okay, come on, you guys. Come on.
Come on.
Come on. Yeah.
You think I can take off my brace in the race?
I'll tell you what, we can ask your mom and dad, but I think it'll be all right.
Yeah!
Why don't you invite me to dinner Saturday night?
I'll cook.
What?
Well, I'd invite you to my place, but my furniture's still coming in.
Oh.
What do you think?
About what?
About me cooking dinner over at your place tomorrow night. I make a mean chicken casserole.
Oh, the last chicken dish I cooked, they made. What?
Oh, that's funny.
What?
The last chicken dish you cooked, Lady Mary.
That is kind of funny.
So what do you got for Saturday night? What is it, poker, bridge, your favorite TV show? Any of the above?
None of the above.
Good. How about 7?
7's fine.
Terrific. I'll see you at 5.
5?
Sure. I'm going to need some time if dinner's going to be ready by 7.
Anything you say, Coach.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks.
Okay.
My partner let me off of work early today, so I baked a fresh batch of healthy-type cookies.
Oh. Yay, cookies!
Yay. Yay. Come on, you guys. Yay, cookies. 1, 2. Come on, Mary. Hey, go around the back, okay? Have you got time for a cup of coffee and a cookie?
Sure.
Sounds great. They're on the dining room table, you guys.
Gee, Sam, you know, you're looking really good lately.
Well, thanks. That's nice to hear.
Yeah. Want to share your secrets?
No secret, just get a little exercise.
You got a new boyfriend, I hear.
Don't believe everything you hear, Linda.
You're not involved with him?
With who?
Mr. Olympics.
Who?
Bud. Hasn't he given you all that crap about Special Olympics yet?
Well, you know, it seems to me that those kids really get a kick out of that.
No, they're just being exploited. My kid's not going to be put out there on display for everyone to feel sorry for. Now, hey, Bud's all right. Just don't expect too much. I mean, a serious thing for women like us, it's just hard.
I know.
What man wants to step into a situation where he has to help raise a retarded kid?
There are exceptions.
Oh, yeah? Show me. Our job isn't ended just because they get older. We're in this for the duration.
We all can't do cookies out in the backyard.
All right.
We have to go clean up here.
Take what you want and scoop. Feed the birds. Okay?
Let's go.
No. Yeah, well, go on now. Come on. No more joking.
Let me take your milk
one,
for
two,
you.
Three,
come on.
Go. One last one.
Okay.
Great.
Out in the backyard. Oh, wait for me there.
Listen, Sam, I didn't mean to sound like the voice of doom back there. I know you've been stung before. I really wouldn't want to see that happen again.
I know, thanks.
Yeah, no one can understand that one better than me. Oh, this coffee. Whew. Hope the cookies taste better than this. I better round up my troops. Just hang in there, kiddo.
I'll be fine.
I know you will.
Whoa! I'm coming!
So what do you need?
Wrench.
That's this, right?
Yes.
Be patient with your mother. Not bad.
Huh?
Oh, I keep forgetting you're a kid.
Hey there!
Hi. John, look out for cars, both ways.
That's it.
Hi, Caroline.
Hi, sweetheart.
I love you.
I love you, too. Hi.
Hi.
I'm Caroline.
Oh,
hi. Sam's multi-million dollar partner.
Oh, right. Hi, I'm Bud Aaron.
Yes, I know. This is my son, Greg.
Hey, Greg.
Sorry.
Hi. Listen, should I go get Sam?
Oh, no. I was just thinking, Greg's dad is coming over soon. Why don't you all come over for some dessert?
Oh, thanks. But, I already...
I'll cook dinner.
Budge cooked dinner?
Well...
How did Sam arrange that?
Actually, that was my idea.
Oh, wow. If she lets you get away, I'm giving up on her. Oh, here comes my ex-dream boat now. Hi. I want you to meet somebody.
Okie dokie. Hi, guy.
Hi. This is Sam's friend, Bud Heron.
Hi.
Greg Sanders.
How are you?
Good to see you. Oh, gotta check my chicken.
Chicken.
He just say he had to check his chicken?
Isn't that great?
It's great that he has to check his chicken?
That's right.
Well, he left me with a gorgeous chick, so what's it all?
You're impossible.
Dinner's ready, and there's plenty for everybody.
Hey. That's a wonderful
Thanks anyway. I just brought back a couple of pizza.
Okay, next time.
Right.
Right.
John.
Oh, Greg.
Do you think me, please?
Yeah.
How's it go?
Have a good dinner.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you.
Ta-da!
Oh, I would rather have had chicken.
I'd rather have had chicken.
Well, you were right.
About what?
You make a mean chicken casserole.
The chicken's nice.
Yeah, that's what I just told them.
Hey, the vegetables in the salad weren't bad either.
Yeah. Modesty, however, is not one of your strong points.
I'll work on that.
What do you ever cook?
Here, sweetheart.
Hey, Flash, you got a little something on your chin there.
Oh. Okay, good, Bob.
You got it. Is everybody ready for dessert?
I think John should be.
I want dessert.
It's all ready. We'll have him stuffed and sleeping in no time.
John, what's he doing in there? Peek around. Can't you see?
No.
What's it gonna be? What's that noise?
Hot stuff!
Hot stuff! Wow. Couldn't you wait? Sorry, I thought this was somebody else.
Is this Samantha Kendall?
Yes, it is.
Hey, Sam, how you doing?
Who is this, please?
It's me, Monkey.
Larry?
Bingo!
Where are you?
I'm in a phone booth. Listen, I got served with those child support papers. You think I could come by and talk to you about them?
No, my lawyer wouldn't like that.
Oh, come on, Sam.
No, Larry.
I'd really love to see you.
I'm sorry, I've got company, so I can't really talk.
I understand. Maybe tomorrow.
I'll talk to you after the case is settled.
Oh, Sam.
Goodbye, Larry. I will not let this spoil my evening. Not let this spoil my evening.
Now, a long time ago, there lived a man named Babe Ruth. And some people think he was probably the greatest baseball player that ever lived. You know how many home runs he hit in his lifetime?
Oh.
714. He also struck out 1,000 times.
Yeah.
And you know how come he hit so many home runs?
Why?
Because he went for it. Because he didn't care if he struck out. So he hit those home runs.
Table's cleared. Wow, this must break the record for getting ready for bed.
How fast, Mom?
Yeah, I guess he's doing everything faster.